Pixpa complete tutorial for beginners step by step. Hello guys, Ilya here, and in this video I'm going to show you how can we easily create our own website using pixpa.com. So they provide us the opportunity to customize their own templates. In order to get started, we need to visit pixpa.com, and here we are on our start page. In the top of the screen we can find some information about their product, templates, examples, and of course pricing. So in order to get started, we need to click on start for free or get started free. They provide us the opportunity to this free trial, so we'll have to create an account using Gmail, or we can easily create it with any mail. So I already have it, so I just click on get started free and I'll come to my home page here, and you also come here after your registration. As you can see in the left side, we can find the menu with dashboard where you can find all the information about our stuff, website area, store, client, gallery, and so on. So in this case we are going to use only a dashboard here. In the top of the screen we can find our sites here where we can create a new website or do some other stuff. Also we can deal with upgrade version. I will discover it a little bit later. So let's click on my sites here, and as you can see I have my website, but let's try to add a new website here, and we'll come to our templates here where we can find a lot of different templates we can easily use. We can switch them between different categories like popular, new, change the type, portfolio, online store, businesses, blog, one page, for creative, for fashion and style, as you can see, personal, business and services. So let's go to personal and let's try to use blog area where we can find some cool templates we can easily customize. There are a lot of different templates, not too much, but I think that's enough to create. So for example, let's try to use this one here, so we can easily click on preview or we can start. So let's click on start, and we need to choose the name of our the name of our site. Let it be Helperman. Let it be like this. So 1, 2, 3, add new website, and in a few seconds everything will be created. And we'll come to this page here, basically the same page where we can interact. So we can build a website, customize site design, start the store, and let's click on edit website on the dashboard folder to come to our basically editor. And as you can see, it looks like this. In the left side there is option to deal with site menu and change different options, and in the right side there is option to customize, to see how does it looks like, to change something. So basically it's pretty easy. We can go to navigation or do some other stuff, and as you can see we have blog area. We can go to blog here and we'll find all of our posts where we can simply click on more. We can view, we can edit, we can duplicate or delete, and this is a way of how can we interact with our posts. So also we can add a post here. As you can see, we can just simply click on add a post. We can add the title here, let it be my tutorial. We can change the status to publish, scheduled. We can schedule it, basically we can change the publish time, and here we can add some text here. So let it be best tutorial here, and so on. So in this case we can easily customize. We can add some media, we can add it to media gallery after the blog post, we can add the author. So there are a lot of stuff we can customize, and then we can just simply click on save and everything is done, and in a few seconds it will be successfully added. So this is a way of how can we easily manage our posts here or do some other stuff. So we can switch between different websites as you can see, and basically this is the way. So in the images area we can also add some media to our blog. So we can just simply click on add media. We can change images, videos, or add some text slide. So let's try to add some media. Let it be these numbers here. So I'll just simply click on open. It may take a little time, and then just click on add images. Yeah, basically edit, And as you can see, it was successfully finished. So now we can just simply click on close. And all the photos were successfully added. We can now go to settings, find some gallery settings here, find the design, and that's all. So we can click on view, and in a few seconds, like, we can view them right up here, basically. So now when everything is done, we can try to view how does our design looks like, and it's like still looks like this. So basically, they don't provide us a lot of opportunities. We can go to templates and design to customize some our styles. We can change the template, title and logo, color and spacing, header, menu, galleries, button and links, footer, and so on. So it's not that like intuitive, understandable, so easy start working, but this is a way of how can we do this. So yeah, it's not that like easy to start with. As for me, I tried a lot of different website builders, and yes, so we can easily try to upgrade it. As you can see, we have like some plans, like the most popular is professional, but there are like four plans, like basic, creator, professional, and advanced. So we can find the differences right up here. It means that we can easily start for free, and after that we can decide, is it suitable for us to use Pixpa. As for me, it's definitely like good, but not the best. So I think you need to try once more, maybe Zoho sites or some other stuff. So as for me, it's not that like easy to understand. There's like client gallery here. So as you can see, a lot of pages which are not that intuitively understandable. So yeah, we can also add like some app integrations here, like Google Analytics, YouTube, Vimeo, Instagram, VHCC, Google Sheets, PayPal, Stripe, Google Forms, like PayU, social sharing, photo gallery apps, and so on. A lot of integrations. So maybe it's it may take some time for you to understand how does it works us, but basically, yeah, this is the way of how can we interact with Pixpa to create a website. It was successfully created, as you can see. So we can create like a lot of different signs. We can click on see all websites and we'll come to this page here. Yeah, it looks like this here. We can edit, and so on. So yeah, this is the way of how can we use Pixpa to create a website. Hope guys this video helped you out. If you have any questions, you can write them in the comments below. I wish you a very good day. Goodbye.